A new U.S. study warns of the dangers of using artificial intelligence chatbots in time for America's elections this November. The research by U.S. election officials, researchers, and journalists concluded that the use of chatbots in polls remains premature after the AI models yielded inaccurate responses to election-related queries. Companies involved in the study included the darling of generative artificial intelligence, OpenAI, as well as Google and Facebook's parent company, Meta. They acknowledged challenges in the development of election-related technology and noted efforts to improve experience for voters. Senator J.V. Ercito slams San Juan Mayor Francis Zamora for dragging his constituents in their political rift. Ercito says he is aware that the Zamora's view that his family as their political adversaries. But he adds his local supporters and allies are often affected whenever he raises issues surrounding Zamora's mayorship.
Ang lang apila ko lang kay Mayor Zamora, wala na akong ano eh, wala nang threat sa ngayon, no? Ako po, nasa Senado na, ang mami ko, retired na, 82 years old. Ang apila ko lang, sana kami na lang mag-abangayan sa politika. Ang kawawa yung tao eh, no? Yun ang hindi ko talaga matiis dahil every time magsasalta ako, binabawian naman yung mga tao.
Senator Ercito also says he urged the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee to probe alleged anomalies in the TUPAD program for disadvantaged or displaced workers. He earlier accused the San Juan City government of being involved in alleged corrupt activities in the cash aid program. Zamora has denied these allegations and notes that the TUPAD program is a national government endeavor.
TUPAD po is a national government program. Hindi ho namin hawak ang salaries. No? Yan po ay sa DOLE at meron nga pong system wherein you will have to claim these salaries sa Palawan. Okay? Meron pong tamang listing na ginagawa kung sino ang beneficiaryo. Meron pong ID na galing mismo sa DOLE.
In today's numbers that matter, the Banco Central expects Philippine inflation settling between 2.8% to 3.6%. The figures are now well within government's full-year target of 2 to 4%. Consumer price index in the Philippines came in at 2.8% in January, which is the lowest since October 2020. The central bank says higher prices of rice, meat, and fish may drive inflation up, as well as the recent increases in petroleum prices and electricity rates. But it notes fruit and sugar prices may keep inflation down. The Bank of the Philippine Islands wealth management arm expecting a double-digit growth in its assets under management, or AUM, this year. BPI's wealth AUM reached 1.2 trillion pesos last year. That's a 40% increase from 2022's 875 billion pesos. For this year, the bank is expecting its AUM to grow 15 to 20%. That's on track for its 3 trillion pesos target by 2026.
We actually increased our market share by about 300 basis points. So it's now close to 20%. So we're very excited about this outcome. It has been, a very busy year for the organization. We have implemented a lot of initiatives and we're firing on all cylinders across our different market segments, from institutional business, our high net worth segment, our retail segment. All those segments are actually showing very impressive growth, and we're very happy to have seen that in 2023, and looking forward to sustaining this momentum this year.